Back here at home, Presidential Advisor for Entrepreneurship, Joy Concepcion, who's always advocated for reopening, is sounding the alarm on low booster rates and expiring vaccines, things that could derail our economic recovery. He joins us live this morning to talk more about these issues. Joey, good morning. Thank you so much for joining us.
Good morning, Mimi.
All right. So before we get to the vaccines, do you think we're ready to further downgrade to alert level zero? Essentially, take all the gloves off. I mean, do we even know the specifics and the terms of alert level zero yet? The last we checked, the IATF is still figuring it out.
Well, ultimately, when especially at the current state that we're in, despite all the rallies, cases are still going down. Mm-hmm. Okta said that there seems to be nothing out there that is a threat at this point in time, then most countries would move to remove the alert level now. But in our case, I guess they want to be conservative since rallies are ongoing and there are a lot of people there. So it's the right thing to do. But definitely, I think we would qualify to really remove the alert because there's no impending threat right now in the country. But as I was saying, my biggest concern really right now is our booster shots. No, the vaccination rates have been going up. NCR is over 100%. But if you look at the booster uptake, it's way, way below what is expected. No, so that is the challenge right now. 30% booster rate in NCR is quite low.
Mm-hmm. That's 30% boost rate in NCR, 13.13% for the whole country.
30.
That's 30, for NCR.
For NCR, yes.
And it's
but
for
if you look at the
country,
other areas,
it's 1.3, right?
Well, yes, 13% because many in the different regions are way below 10%. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So, you can understand a bit. Some of these areas took their primary doses much later than NCR. So mm-hmm. NCR had a head start because we focused the vaccines when there was not enough in NCR. But still, I mean, the booster rate in the provinces are very low. So, and the challenging part here is that these vaccines, I was looking at the latest data, they're all going to expire by my estimate start. Some have already expired, even from the private sector's orders. We have maybe overbought a bit, but you know that is part of our core conservatism. No, but the government, you know, the uptake is going to affect, and these vaccines expire sometime June, July, mm-hmm. and once that happens, I don't see any orders coming in because you know the new administration will take over, and I think this government is leaving it up to the next administration to make that decision. No, but again, if the Filipino people will not take the booster shots, then why even procure the vaccines for boosters? Because they will just go to waste. So I was proposing that maybe we can set a deadline. Everybody should take the booster shots before June. Or else you can implement that entry to business establishments such as restaurants will be restricted to those who have not taken yet the booster shots by June. So you give them a lead time. No?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Is there anything else that the government can do, Joey, to encourage everyone to get their booster shots aside from, you know, making it mandatory for those entering commercial establishments?
Well, right now they are using vaccination cards prior to entry. And we know that these vaccination cards, I mean, the vaccines, over time, not immediate, over time will wane. So you have to protect for the future. I'm suggesting it, replacing it with booster cards. But, you know, I think they're also approaching it. They're going down closer to the people, to the communities, to the markets and all of that. And I think they will try to approach these citizens and persuade them. No? And of course, maybe if we're able to implement the drug stores, you know, to start inoculating our people, similar to what's being done in America, then that might be a big help. You know? Mm-hmm. So it becomes really closer to the people, more convenient. But you know, time is running out. And of course, election is happening. People are campaigning. Many of our local leaders are running for re-election or running. So their focus will be split. You know? Because of all the election campaigning that's now ongoing. So that could be also another reason why there is a slowdown. No? But nevertheless, I don't see any problem between now till June, July, but there could be a problem down the road as immunity would wane if the, especially if the third, the third booster shot, I mean, the first booster shot is not taken. And mm-hmm. primary doses, I think everybody were up there in the 70-80%. So that's going to give us some protection. Mm-hmm. But more towards the third quarter, late third quarter, we could be at risk.
Joey, you mentioned expiring vaccines. How much are we talking about?
Well, quite a number. I mean, you're looking at 100,000, a million. I mean, it all depends. I mean, it'll be a lot. People will not take their booster shots. No, mm-hmm. it'll be a lot.
And right now, Joey, we're not procuring any new vaccines?
No, I don't see anything. But I'm told that there's a proposed budget to buy vaccines. I was told that Moderna is giving an offer for us to return the Moderna vaccines in exchange for new. They will replace the expired, provided that we have to purchase more vaccines. But again, that's something that I think the government will have to decide. Maybe the next administration will have to decide. I don't think the administration will want to take that responsibility, considering that we still have vaccines that are still usable. No, they're still going to expire in June, so there is enough time. I mean, we still have April, May, so we have to convince them. There's no other way, but our citizens have to take that, or else moving forward, purchasing vaccines for the Filipino people may just go to waste if nobody wants to take it. So let's see what happens, and that's why I'm pushing really hard, because whereas I'm very bullish, you know, the economy is doing extremely well, Mimi. I mean, people have bounced back. You can see that there is more activity, more mobility, and school is going to open. That will further improve, you know, mobility and purchasing power. Of course, we have inflation hitting us because of the Ukraine crisis, but nevertheless, we're bouncing back. So, but with all of this said, and the Ukraine-Russia crisis, we cannot afford another surge. That's going to be devastating, because people are recovering. To have another surge will stall the momentum of many of our MSMEs, who are the ones severely challenged in this pandemic. And tourism has opened up, and it's starting to, you know, really draw more mobility in that sector. So we have to take care. I mean, we're lucky, no, that the Philippines is now the best in Asia. I mean, our neighbors are facing a lot of challenges with their health situation, but in here in the Philippines, we're doing fine. And so I have to credit the Duterte administration and the private sector for a job well done.
Mm-hmm. Actually, we've heard from some scientists some possible explanations why the Philippines may be doing better. Number one, we front-loaded the surge. We had it early this year before everybody else got it. And secondly, it could possibly be because we have so many different brands of vaccines, so the coverage, you know, tends to have a wider scope as well. Joey, let's talk about the business side, because you are a businessman yourself. How's the reopening doing so far? I know you said you're bullish, you're seeing recovery, but you know, we know December is always strong because it's always the time when everyone shops for the holidays, and then Omicron hit us in January. When I personally speak with investors and businesses, I seem to get the impression that everyone's still hesitant. You know, not able to see clearly 3 to 6 months down the road. They just want to wait and see. They don't want to plan that far ahead, which means a very slow pickup in business. Is that also something that you're, is that also a sentiment you're getting from the MSMEs you work with?
Well, of course, many of the MSMEs had to restructure their loans. Not all of them have the capability of really having enough assets to mortgage. No? So, and for that to happen, the banks have to have confidence that, yes, the Philippine economy is open. That's why I and the rest of the team really worked hard together with some members of the IATF to really push for the opening of the economy. And that always hinges on the health situation of the country. So as we, the strategy of vaccinating our people, especially with the primary doses, really worked well. Mm-hmm. Chairman Avalos did a great job for Metro Manila. That's why you can see the vaccination rate in NCR was very high. So as we succeeded in Metro Manila, that was rolled out through the provinces, and they too did well, and the vaccination rates in the provinces are 60-80%. So right now the coast is fine. Octa sees great so far, no threat out there, and I'm just raising a yellow flag, because if we don't maintain the immunity wall, which has been created, no? Of course, the immunity wall was created through vaccination. That's number one. And of course, Omicron, to me, was a blessing in a sense, whereby a lot of people got infected, so they had natural immunity. Mm-hmm. Those vaccinated were not hospitalized, so that was a good thing. And so you added two together, so our immunity wall strengthened. But mm-hmm. over time, both vaccines and natural immunity do wane.
Mm-hmm. And if we don't get that boost, if we don't get a substantial portion of the population boosted, Joey, do you think the Philippine economy can hit the 7 to 9% recovery, the growth number that this government set for this year?
Well, the first quarter, I mean, last year, in December, the last quarter, because of the private sector and government, we did an early lockdown. So we were able to save the fourth quarter and hit a GDP of 7.7. Mm-hmm. Now with the Ukraine-Russia crisis, with inflation numbers really moving up, and there's no choice because the oil and other commodities such as wheat, et cetera, have gone up. Prices are moving up. And the problem there is that we have to pass this on to the consumer. The consumer can only take so much. So they might be a slowdown in purchasing. No? So you would have I don't know if we will still be able to hit those growth numbers, because the price increases are absolutely at a very high percentage. I mean, oil is going up by what? I mean, diesel and all of that, $8, $9. Mm-hmm. And of course, other finished goods will also go up. So that might slow down, you know, consumer spending, which might hamper our growth. And although the health situation is fine, business, I think, will continue. But if you get a variant out there and our wall of immunity has been somehow weakened, then we could have a surge, and we could have, again, back to this alert levels that may take it up to alert level 3 or alert level 4, which will again stall the economic recovery that has started and is doing fine.
Mm-hmm. All right. We can't afford to go back into lockdown. Joey, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you, Bimi.
All right.